This is the right side of the engine. I've removed the cover to expose the clutch on this side. I'm removing now the last one of the four clutch springs. When I remove this cover, I can now take apart the clutch plates. As you'll see, this one has the teeth on the outside and it hooks up to the outside of the clutch. This one has the teeth on the inside and it hooks up to the inside of the clutch. I'd like to demonstrate to you quickly what it looks like when the inside part of the clutch and the outside part of the clutch are not moving together. So what we have here, if I take this first clutch plate off, you'll see we have the plates with the teeth on the inside rotating and rubbing against the plates with the teeth on the outside. So what is happening is that the two want to rotate together, but because one is not in the same and not rotating at the same speed, they are creating friction. And eventually, with the force of friction, the two will rotate together like so. And this can happen vice versa as well. If, for example, the crankshaft is spinning, but the inside part of the clutch is in place, then we have this. And if you can see on the other side, the sprocket at this point is not moving up until the two are able to rotate together at the same speed. The crankshaft through these sprockets turns the outside part of the clutch. So the outside part of the clutch is what is linked to the movement of the piston, and the inside of the clutch is what is linked to the sprocket through the transmission. And here is where the two of them become synchronized, is that when we let go of the clutch, we are allowing these plates to rub on each other and eventually, through friction, to turn at the same speed. I have the clutch reassembled, and I'm going to demonstrate to you what it would look like if we were pulling on the clutch lever on the left side of the handlebar. This is where the cable to that clutch lever is attached to normally. And when I pull on it, excuse me, you can see the clutch cover separates. Let me zoom in so you can get a better look at that. Now I'm pulling on it. Even though it's a very small noticeable difference, as you can see here, I'm pulling on it and now I let go. Pulling on it, let go. So the clutch cover moves away from, moves away, pushing up against the clutch springs, thereby reducing the friction between the clutch plates. Let me demonstrate this. Pulling, let go. Pulling, let go. When we pull the lever on the left side of the handlebar, we're pulling on the clutch, and the cable that is attached to that lever, the other end of it is attached to here on the top of the engine. Now let me explain what that does. It is held in place by this screw, which I've already loosened, and it has a spring on it, which is how this thing comes back to its position back here. When we pull the clutch lever, it's actually moving forward like this. And what this does, let me pull it out for you to see. If you see here at the bottom of that rod, it has that shape. So when we pull the lever, it turns like so. And the effect of this is, let me go back to the other side to explain that to you. It's moving a rod. There's a rod that pushes up against the bottom of this stick about here, And what it does with that is it pushes that rod to the right, to the right side of the engine. Let me explain that from the other side. If we follow the rod that the other end of the clutch cable is attached to, as you can see, it's actually coming up to the other end of the shaft. And what it's touching on is this rod. This rod sits inside here, all the way to the other side. And on the other end of it is this ball, which is there to reduce friction, and the clutch cover. This clutch cover sits inside of that shaft, and so when we pull the clutch lever, pushing this rod out towards us, what it does is it pushes away the clutch cover, and that is how we get the reduction in friction between the clutch plates, because this clutch cover, it's mounted onto the clutch with these clutch springs. And those clutch springs are what increase the friction between the plates. So by pushing those, the clutch cover out, we are allowing more space between the clutch plates, and that reduces the amount of friction.